disappeared. In my understanding, that's like NSA hologram. Project Bluebeam is like a psychological warfare stuff. They use a lot of holographic stuff.
Could you explain more about Project Bluebeam?
It's the holograms, you know, you can project
this group of people. Just into the mind or into the...
You can project it, you know, holographic technology. Project a group of people walking on there and they'll look solid, three-dimensional. They'll be holograms, you know.
Where would the projectors be housed in order to do this? I mean, with the projector?
Possibly.
Do they have to set things up first?
I don't know exactly where it's projected from. Possibly satellite, possibly a van part somewhere. I don't know, but I know the holograms are very realistic. Yeah, I just like, basically, Project Mannequin, a lot of it is about harnessing radio waves, brain waves, and it's about sending them out through televisions, mobile phones, and mobile phone masks.
Yeah.
It's like they're sending out frequencies, because everybody's got a telepathic receiver, like a radio receiver, the pineal gland in the brain.
So they're using the broadcast communication system as a mechanism for mind control or mind implantation of ideas or what?
Yeah, but what they're doing is they're dampening down the consciousness. My main message is about the missing children and about the children that are being abused and satanically murdered in the facilities. So basically, they're taking children into the bases, because there's like 25,000 children go missing a year in this country. And what they're doing is they've got brain implants, and they're ritually murdering them. They're like,
what kind of ritual?
They're cutting their throats, they're cutting their hands off. They're things based around that in rituals. And at the time of death, they're recording the brain waves of the children onto a computer.
How are they doing that?
By radio wave, because brain waves and radio waves are the same thing. So at the time that they record those frequencies from the brain implant onto a computer, and then what they're doing is they're sending that radio wave, that frequency, out through phone masks, through satellite and TVs, sending it out, and it's causing the crime rate to go up. It's causing people's anxiety levels to go up. And what they can do is they can, it's causing sexual abuse, drug abuse, alcohol abuse to go up. And what they can do is, by the means of death, they murder the children, they can attack the population's chakras. So when they cut a child's throat and record that type of death from that frequency from their brain implant onto the computer, they send that out, and that stops people being able to talk to each other properly from the heart. It's the effect.
Do you think this child
is jogging past the woods there a couple of weeks before, like every night, and on about four, I think it was about four separate nights, he had screams coming out of the woods. This was even before the two children were found, and then the military sealed the area up. And then, like in the New Forest, there's children's bodies being found there, with the skin removed and things like that.
It's like the mutilation problem.
Yeah, and like eyeballs removed, and basically the lymphatic system removed, like the tongues, the eyeballs, the genitalia. Well, these I'm connected to an intelligence group called Group 5A. It's part of British intelligence, connected to the United Nations. They basically, a few years back, they were up in the Brecon Beacons area, and there's an underground NSA base under the Brecon Beacons.
Yeah.
They were...
the experimentation base there, is that
right? Yeah, Brecon Beacons. They were around the area, and they were being called to the scene of camper vans around the area. People were missing and disappeared from the camper vans. And they basically got called to one scene, and there'd been two bodies found, a young boy and a young girl there. And they went to the scene, had to seal off the area, military style.
Yeah.
And their eyeballs had been removed, half the skin was missing, tongues, genitals. And basically the Group 5-8 guys showed the photographs to a friend of mine, and he was a researcher who was meant to get the story out. But then he had his house burned down after that.
Who is doing the mutilations? Is it a government program or what?
The information that I've got, I'd go with its factions in the Greys and the Reptilians that are working with the NSA on the bases. I think they're harvesting the lymphatic system, and this gets into like the Dulce material,
yeah,
where Greys have been seen in vats with human body parts being mixed around. They're basically absorbing the protein mixture through osmosis through their skin. I think they've got some kind of genetic disorder that the digestive system doesn't work properly.
So are the Greys and the Reptilians based here? You know, like a Dulce facility here?
Well, Barry King says he's seen, he saw Greys and Reptilians at the Berkshire base.
You've seen things?
I've never seen any Greys or Reptilians at the base. I've seen things that look like small kind of gargoyles, and they were wearing robes, but they weren't Greys.
And do you think that they were actually earthly based, genetically altered human beings, or do you think they were actually what's your opinion of what those beings were? How many did you see?
I saw three of them. I mean, that's a long story in itself. You can go into that if you want.
Yeah, well, we've got a couple of minutes if you can allude to it.
Okay, that was basically well, in 1981, when it was taken through Green and Common, I saw things in cages, like large wolves and dogs there. But I think they were genetic creations, military creations. But these things, basically, this was on the 4th of August last year. Again, I went out again down to the cliffs, and there was a firefly waiting for me again. This has been happening for years.
Yeah.
It turns out, under hypnosis, I've gone out regularly and met them.
Yeah.
I think it was
a good idea to set that up as a surveillance point and catch it on film one night.
Yeah.
Does it happen in daylight or
no? No, late at night. And there's been a lot of activity in my house, bedroom. Small greys appearing, reptilians appearing. But now I can't even sleep in the house by myself. I'm like 30 years old.
Are they projected? Are they mannequin? Are they blue beam projections?
That's what I thought, but these seem very real. They could be holographic projections. They seem very real.
So you had those abductions last year. What about this year?
It's been close encounters at night. Small greys, tall greys, reptilians. The PLFs have got the round eyes, and the real greys have got the oval eyes.
Yeah.
The ones I've seen in my bedroom have got the oval eyes.
Right.
And then wake up paralyzed, and you're trying to shout and move, but you can't. And you know, the situation's got so bad, this is happening once every couple of weeks. I'm seeing something in the room.
Is there any way that you can afford that, leave a camera running around?
Yeah, I've wanted to get some camera set up. I've wanted to actually take a Geiger counter in, because I can see radio waves, I can physically see radiation, because that's part of my training project, Mannequin. I can tune my eyes in like a digital camera, and there's very high levels of radiation in the room.
Yeah.
But what this is called non-ionizing radiation.
Yeah,
that's it. This is non-ionizing radiation. It doesn't get in your cells and make you sick. What they're doing is they're using extremely high frequency radiation and punching a hole, possibly from underground bases, and then coming into the room.
Now, just for the record, we're in Cornwall.
Yeah.
So you're talking about everything happening here in Cornwall.
Around Cornwall in St. Ives, yeah.
St. Ives.
I think Project Mannequin has a life plan for you. Every school you go to, every university, everywhere you live, is planned by the project for you. And I think they wanted to have me down here in the middle of nowhere by the cliffs, because I've regularly gone down to the cliffs late at night and been picked up in military abductions.